No strawberries.
Situation and
and get in for sweet beer. For Hansel and for Gretel, there's not a lot of cheer. Whatever will become of them, the future isn't clear. But one thing's sure, for two so poor, it's desperate living here.
As night fell on the poor family, Hansel and Gretel took a threadbare blanket each and went to bed in the next room.
But being so cold and hungry, they could not sleep. Instead, they just lie awake, huddled together, listening with horror as their stepmother revealed to their father a wicked and dastardly plan.
My love, surely there's another way.
Just use your loaf, you oaf. Too many mouths to feed and not enough food. What else you suggest?
But to take them to the forest and just leave them. They'll never survive.
Of course, that's the idea.
What was that, my love?
I said they're clever children. They'll find food and shelter, and then when we're back on our feet again, we'll go and we'll find them. That's not if they've been eaten by wolves or bears.
What was that, my love?
I said it's time we went upstairs. You know, get some rest for the long day ahead. Everything's gonna be fine. Just trust.
What a wicked woman, and you wander around the world. Perhaps you'll lead an evil life, and a lonely smile.
Come a little closer, and you can hold my hand. Be a little bolder, that's it, you understand.
What a wicked woman, and you wander around the world. There has to be an evil eye, and a holy smile.
Take them to the forest, and don't you bring them back. They'll survive the weather, but not a wolf attack.
What a wicked woman, and you wander around the world. There has to be an evil mind behind a holy smile. That smile. That smile.
The family gathered around the table. Hansel and Gretel were each given a napkin with bright crumbs in it. Told by their stepmother that they are heading out for the forest for the day to find wild mushrooms and the deer.
Unaware, the two children knew of their stepmother's plan to leave them in the forest, the two grown-ups set off at a brisk pace.
Listen, Gretel, as we make our way through the forest, we shall come to some slice of their chicken.
And when our loving parents bring us, it's a full of children. Will you two brats stop dawdling and hurry up?
Your mother and I are going, oh, I can't do this.
Oh, for pity's sakes, where's your backbone? Children, your father and I are going to go collect some wild mushrooms.
We wouldn't want you to get lost.
So you stay here and make a fire. Come on, you gutless wonder. At last, I can almost feel the fur coat around my shoulders. Ha!
We perform.
surprise.
But Hansel, where are the breadcrumbs?
The two children frantically scoured the area, but not a single breadcrumb was to be found.
With no idea what direction to go in, they stumbled even deeper into the forest.
Our supplies are running low. No one has come this way for days now. Soon, there'll be nothing left for me.
Rabbi, show up at that spare tire. You've got enough stored up in there. What about the rest of us? We're the ones suffering.
Why are people coming in force? It's not as ever on a grand one.
We're just relieving them of any valuables.
Well, I guess we'll get you back. People just to learn to ask a little was return to the forest for doing something awesome.
You mean part of us being here?
Yes, a plate from us. Yes, a plate from us being here. It's a bit creepy. Do you know what I mean?
Ha! You're going soft. Honestly, you need to toughen up a bit. We're thieves, we're gonna say. The people are finding us, we need to find people. Let's get out there and start robbing.
Your fortunes have just begun to turn for the worst.
Grab them, guys.
But they're just children. It's not like they'll be carrying any loot.
Or food. Look at them. They couldn't have eaten anything.
They probably do plots. They'll have parents who will pay a handsome ransom to get the little darlings back.
Yeah, let's grab them.
Right,
yeah,
I'm up yeah, already ran to know.
Oh, this is no use. I'm not tie someone's hands behind the back. I'm a robber, not a kidnapper. Yeah, not me. Definitely.
Excuse me, but if you let go of me, I might be able to help. I'm an expert, not tire.
That's pretty civil of you, miss, if you wouldn't mind.
Gretel, what are you thinking?
Trust me, Hansel.
Okay, the rest of you, grab a partner and gather around.
So, the rope goes over, then under, through the loop twice, then you pull it tight.
There, he's not going anywhere. Right, now you try.
Quite a good effort all around. Now, you two need to appreciate how good a knot feels around the rope. So, if you'll allow me.
Yeah, sure.
There, you got 24 hours to sum up 5,000.
What the pardon me for asking?
But where are the prisoners?
They're gone. Sorry. I'm sorry.
They're gone.
Sorry.
Brilliant.
Not my fault.
Come on, just wait.
Eventually, after hours of walking, two children came to a clearing in the forest, thinking that there was no hope, they huddled together for comfort.
Are you indeed a fool, children?
What said that?
Surely no one talking trees.
Are your tummies rumbling and grumbling?
Come on, Hansel. We can't stay here.
Don't rattle, eh, children? We've been expecting you.
Gretel, look!
Feet and straight beyond you. Why are there trees?
This way, the treasures too. The lakes of which you've never imagined. This is a place where all your worries and fears disappear. Come and see.
Feast your eyes and your half-starved bellies on this.
Come and help yourself to anything and everything. It's all free, and it's all for you.
Look at this, a house made of gingerbread. Yes, that is what we said, a house made of gingerbread. Quality and quantity unlimited. No one's keeping tabs. Feast your eyes on all you could ever want. All you could ever want. And don't let your nonchalant. It's a kind of edible restaurant. And it's up for grabs. And it's up for grabs.
What an astonishing house. Its bricks were made out of gingerbread held together by Warner Butter Rice. With window panes made out of sugar glass and licorice putty. And sills made out of moist strawberry sponge cake.
On top of the taffy roof tent sat a chimney pot with rope, which fell across a pink candy floss. Instead of wood, the front door was fashioned from a huge, dark, rich piece of chocolate studded with golden chocolate coins.
Each flower which grew around the foot of this enchanted globe had sweet, crunchy petals that oozed the sap with thick, sticky honey. Even the cobwebs in the hidden corners were delicately spun sugar, sparkling in the fading light.
As the strange little goblin puts it, this is a house unlike any of the children have ever seen. And the thing that made this house normal was someone who lives there.
Look, children, I can see my sparkly little friends invited to my delightful, isn't it? It has to be the property expert called Chocolate Box here, which is quite an accurate description in more ways.
We're so sorry for eating your house.
Uninvited.
Oh, my dear, please eat your fill. I love nothing more than to, how can I look? And to have children over to eat.
Well, thank you.
We were, but we're very...
You're welcome. All I ask is that you stay a few days to help me with your domestic work. Let me get to see our poor eyes.
Well, we'd be happy to, but don't these
friends of yours help at all?
Oh, they're a little too frisky to help us. They tend to help me with more important matters. Thank you, sir. So you may leave us now. Now, my dear, can you leave yourself? I'm excited for a
thank you.
belong, got to be strong, better than one is two.
So this is how the days pass. Grandma spent her hours slaving away and preparing huge platters of food for Hansel. And each day, the old woman would check and see if her intensive feed program was having the desired
result. Right, let's see if we made any progress today. With the amount of food you're getting, that kitchen is bursting right now. Let's have some paper.
And every day, she asked Hansel to help his finger do the bunch. But being so short-sighted, she did not know that he was in fact poking a chicken bone through the bun, not his finger. A chicken bone he had kept since the very first meal Gretel had brought him.
What? It can't be true. You've not put on a single ounce. In fact, you're losing weight.
You've not been jogging in there, have you?
There's only one day left until her planned banquet. It looked as if it was going to be nothing but skin bone. So she ordered Gretel to bring a double-sized platter of food for Hansel to eat. And then she ordered the goblins to stand guard to make sure not a single morsel was left.
Have you finished yet?
Every last morsel. Good. If he would have even left one morsel, he would have punished us.
You're afraid of him, aren't you?
Why don't you all just run away?
She can't spell. She's forced us to stay here and help her catch children. She says if we fail to catch any, she'll eat us instead.
We should be thanking you, really. So it's lucky for us that he came when he did.
Silence! You're not to be making friends with the prisoner! Come.
We don't make preparations for tomorrow's feast.
Oh,
grabbed Gretel and dragged her towards the cauldron.
Hansel watched in horror from his cage.
Let her go, you old hag!
You be quiet. I'll deal with you later. Right, you get it.
Her mind depended on it. Suddenly she saw a light at the end of the very long and very dark tunnel. She had an idea.
I'm never going to fit in there. It's much too small.
Of course you will. You'll just have to curl up.
Even if I curled up into the smallest ball possible, there's still no way I could fit into that. What a useless lump of old iron that is.
How dare you? I'll have you know this pipe pot is cooked chicken for my mother.
Well, children have got a lot bigger since those times because there's still no way one could fit through these days.
Yes, they could. Big enough for a grown-up.
Well, prove it then.
So the old woman angrily climbed into the pot, muttering to herself while children had no respect for their elders.
Perhaps you'd like to give me the key? You wouldn't want to rest in the water.
What? Oh, yes. Here. Ooh, it's a bit warm. There you see, a perfect fit.
Like you're right. You vile, evil woman. Your days of being children are over.
Now rush to Hansel's cage and turn the cage and turn the lock. Hansel jumped out and embraced his sister.
Gretel, you were amazing, but quit before those helpers could respond.
Stop!
You run, Gretel, all over the wall.
No, children, you misunderstand. We were going to save you.
Thank God.
Oh, yes, now we two are free of the evil witch. We can spend the rest of our days living without fear, all because of your bravery. We should be thanking you, really. So, we know you are far from home, so please allow us to guide you out of the forest.
Well, if you're sure,
it would be our pleasure. You believe in our fairy tale. If you don't, you are Peace.